Darnisha, when were you in the class? Like not 8 years ago, 9 years ago?
Yeah, I took the class my first semester freshman year in 2017.
본격적인 강의 시작 전 강의를 위해 고생해주고 있는 총괄 스텝 친구를 반학생들에게 소개해주고 계신 샘 교수님. 그런데
Wait, hang on. Just keep talking. I'll be
Yeah,
right back.
I'm also the person, if you notice anything.
Dude, I got you a gift, by the way, in Colombia last week.
Okay.
No, I really did. No. You're looking like this is a. It's a. It's not a bomb, dude. It's a.
I don't.
Watch my Korean friends. How'd I do? Good? Yeah, that's for you.
앞에 앉아 있는 수백 명의 학생들, 제자이자 스텝으로 일해주고 있는 동료들, 그리고 한국인들에게도 마음을 쓰는 모습이었습니다. 그리고 강의를 시작하는데
Do the math, man.
갑작스런 수학 공격에 당황한 학생.
Dude, I didn't ask her because she's Asian, all right? Because she's going to be good at math, so just know that. Which is a stereotype anyway. Are you good at math, by the way? She's not even good at math. See, I knew that. Like, a little bit. Wait, hang on. Where are you from?
한국인 친구였습니다.
Oh, wait. Hang on. Can I have a microphone? Do you mind? What's your name?
Luna.
Yuna?
Luna.
Luna?
Yes.
Wait, that's your American... That's the name you gave...
Yeah,
Who gave
that's
you
my
that name?
nickname.
Your nickname? Yeah, who gave you that name?
My dad.
Oh, your dad did?
Yeah.
That's cool. What's your Korean name?
My Korean name is Yoo-un.
Yoo-un?
Yes.
You said, I'm like, are you good at math? And you're like, eh. Which means you probably scored like 800 on the SATs, really. Because you're Korean. So you're going to be like, you're going to downplay how good you are.
I'm actually a transfer student, so it's my first semester here, and I didn't take the SAT.
Oh, okay. Okay, but
Yeah.
did you take the Sunan exam?
I did.
How'd you do on the math part?
It's really competitive there, so
Yeah. Well, hold the
I didn't
microphone close.
I didn't do that good.
Yeah, we cut. Okay, but what do you mean? What's not that good?
And
You're. Pro it's the score is probably higher than 95% of the people in this room.
So it's the perfect score is 100,
Yeah.
and like I got 80 something.
80 something.
Yes.
Wait, is that? Dude, are you ready here? She's, this is a Korean thing, right? It's like 81 or 89. There's a big difference. Cause you're, she's gonna downplay, all right? Everything. Cause she can't be like, yeah, I'm really smart. I'm really good at math, you know. 80 what?
But honestly, I'm really not that good
All right,
because,
I got you.
88.
88. Dude. Wait, hang on. Thank you. 88, dude. How would you do on that? How'd you do on it?
I didn't take it.
You didn't take it?
I had calculus in high school.
Yeah, so you're pretty good at math?
I'm pretty good at
math. All right. Okay. You're good.
전형적인 한국 친구의 모습에 교수님도 주변의 학생들도 모두 흥미로우듯 웃음을 지었습니다.
That's like 740 on the SAT?
That's like 740
like
on the
730?
SAT for math?
I know the test. Yeah, that's like 730, 740. That's better than I got. Like,
all right. And where's your ancestry? You're also Korean? Dude. Well, I scored on the math part on the SAT. If I remember correctly, I scored like 430 or something like that. What are you going to do? You know what I mean? All right. dude.
그렇게 가볍게 지나갔던 한국 학생들의 등장. 그런데
Today's class is kind of really rooted in much it emerges out of much of the conversation that was happening in the chat on the stream.
강의 방송 중 전 세계 많은 시청자들이 스트리밍 채팅으로 한국인들은 수학을 잘하더라. 아니다. 공부를 잘하더라. 그냥 한국인이 관심 갖기 시작하면 1등을 따내고 말더라. 이건 한국인뿐만 아니라 아시아인들이 대체로 그렇더라 등 수많은 토론이 이어졌습니다. 그런데 모두들 유전과 인종이나 국가별 타고난 것들에 대한 이야기가 주를 이뤘습니다. 이렇게 유전이나 타고난 것에 대한 토론은 항상 활발하다며 오늘 주제로 삼은 것인데요.
We're just going to kind of work together here today, all right? So remember these data. Question that I have for you is like
이어 예전에도 봤던 자료라며 화면에 뭔가 띄워졌습니다.
When we were having this conversation, did at any point you all think maybe people are just wired differently in our genetics, in our DNA? At any point did you think that? Like, because you look at these great differences here.
우선 모든 인종 중 아시아인의 평균 소득이 가장 높은 점에 대해 질문을 던졌습니다.
Did you think it at all?
I don't really think so.
You didn't? At yeah. some point you didn't look at this and say, hey, maybe us Asians are just a little bit, we're just wired
yeah,
genetically.
I just feel like a lot of rich Asians just immigrate to the US. I feel like that.
Yeah, so it's more of that. So you were thinking that. How about the two of you? Did you go?
No, I didn't really think that.
I didn't think that either.
But could you though? Did you not think it because it's racist to think it? Or did you just really not think it? Because people on the live stream were thinking it. So I'm thinking if people on the live stream were thinking, and I knew that because Jamie, who was talking in my ear throughout class, telling me, because this is an earpiece I wear, that I'm talking to my team. And so on the stream, a lot of people were talking about genetics, man. But you all weren't doing that. Okay, all right.
앞에 나온 지원자 친구 셋 모두 전혀 공감 못한다 답했습니다. 하지만 오늘 강의는 뛰어난 재능과 유전의 연관성에 대해 이야기하는 날이었습니다. 시작부터 난관이 예상되는데.
So, first off, I guess we should introduce the three of you.
Hello everyone, my name is Shardy. I'm from China, yeah.
Where are you from in China?
Wuhan.
Wuhan?
Yeah.
Ah, Wuhan. The source. Do you carry that with you? Like this, everywhere you go, does everyone do what I just did? Oh, Wuhan. Oh. Yeah? Or no? How about in China? Do you feel some, do people from Wuhan carry a certain kind of burden because of COVID or not?
I don't really think so.
Yeah? All right. Okay. Well, let me not, build that up any more than it isn't. All right, man.
Hi, everyone. I'm Tanner. I'm a fourth-year computer engineering student. I'm from Bethlehem, PA.
Hi, everyone. My name is Shreya. I'm from Central Jersey, and I'm a third year.
Where in Central Jersey?
Edison.
Edison. I know Edison. All right. Of course, Edison. You're Indian. Where else would you be from? All right. Edison is like little India. There are more Indians in Edison than in Mumbai. All right. So
오늘은 컴퓨터 공학과 친구들 셋과 함께합니다.
But people are wired differently, right? Genetically speaking. Like do you have roommates?
I do have roommates.
Do you all have these different kind of personalities that
Yeah.
At some level do you think that's just genetic, man? That's not
No, I think it's like we're all from out of state, but like different states. So I think it's like how we grew up. And also like, yeah.
Yeah, I got a roommate from Beijing and a roommate from Taiwan.
Yeah.
I feel like there's a lot of difference between us.
Yeah. How much of it do you think is really wired into them?
I don't really know. I don't really, I got a white roommate when I was a freshman.
Yeah,
and it feels there's a lot of difference at how we treat things.
Okay, so but you're looking more at sociology. If you have more than one child, and you can all think about your families, more than one child, the children grow up with the same parents, the same. If you unless you have step siblings or something like this, you have the same. Man, the same woman contributing sperm and egg and they make a child, but every child's different. You ask any mother or any father, it's like these children are different. One comes out of the womb screaming and hollering and the other comes out of the room really quiet. And 30 years later, the quiet one is still quiet and the one that's screaming and hollering is still screaming and hollering. This kind of stuff, right? So you ask any parent about the power of genes in shaping the behavior of individuals, and the parent will say, absolutely, man. I saw it from the first day I held my child, right? This kind of thing. Okay, not everybody, but that's not uncommon, okay? So that's at the individual level. But now we want to look at groups. So then the question becomes, okay, well, if that's true of individuals, why isn't it true of groups? That we could look at these groups like this and say, like, well, some people are just wired a little bit differently than other people.
그리고 또 다른 자료가 나왔습니다.
This was a slide we used the other day. Enrollment of the top high schools based on test scores. Look at where Asians are 73% of Stuyvesant High School. And the students in New York City who are black and Hispanic, they make up 3.5% of all the students at Stuyvesant High School. Like, how do you not get to a place where at some level you're thinking, That is such a great difference. It's such a vast difference. Genetics at some level must be involved. Do you see how you could think genetics is involved? There's something about Asians. It's not like 30% for Asians and 28% for blacks and Hispanics. It's like 73 and 3.5. So I want to ask you this question very clearly. Do you understand how we might get to the place where we say, yeah, it's got genetics has to be part of this? Do you got it?
I will say it's not about the genetic.
No, and it's not about that. Do you understand how you could conclude that it's genetics? Yeah, you don't see that? The two of you would shake your head yes?
I see where you can get that from, but I'm like, I don't think that's like the prime idea.
Okay, it's not the prime thing, but is you see how you could conclude that it's part of it.
Yeah.
Because this is the problem. When we're having these conversations, people are watching the stream and they're going like, dude, it's about genetics. Like, how do you not think it's at some level about genetics? This is what we're going to explore today, because it just makes sense that people would think that.
우리가 흔히 흑인은 유전적으로 당연히 운동을 잘한다는 편견처럼 아시아인은 당연히 유전적으로 지능이 높다는 편견이 있었습니다. 그런데 오늘 지원자 친구들 셋은 그것은 편견이 확실하기 때문에 사람들이 그런 편견을 갖고 있다는 자체가 이해되지 않는다는 것이었죠. 하지만 수업이 진행될수록 점점 시각을 넓혀갔습니다.
Check this out, by the way. Is anyone on the golf team here? Look at the names here. There was a tournament that Penn State supported. Ivy League, Harvard, Princeton, Columbia, Yale. Look at all the names. Where are they from?
East Asian.
Yeah, China and Korea. Okay, go to the next slice. Okay, here we go. Jacksonville State, Central Michigan, Central Arkansas, wherever that is. See any Koreans or Chinese here? No, because Koreans or Chinese are going to go to the Ivies because that's where they're going to go. And they love playing golf. They're not better at golf because they're better genetically. They're better because they love playing golf. But they don't love it enough to go here. You see how that fits in? Korean parents, you're not going to send your kid to Central Arkansas and play golf. Like, you're just not doing that. You're going to go to the Ivy. We can do that. All right? Okay, so now we're going to go next thing. Now we're going to talk about IQ. PISA is the program. It's a test. It's given to about 600,000 15-year-olds every year. And it measures science, math, reading comprehension. It's real-world problem solving. So it's not an IQ test per se, but it's as close as you're going to get it. And look at the score. Look at who comes out on top. Singapore, China, Japan, Taiwan, Korea, Hong Kong. And then you start up here. Look where the U.S. is. Are you guys that much smarter than us?
No, because parents just push them too much, I think.
Well, I don't know. If you look at this, we think like, oh, you must be really smart. Like, you know, it all comes down to genetics. Remember the questions on the class last week, this question on the stream, on the chat? It's all about genetics. Well, if it's all about genetics, why is it that if we go back 50 years, the United States and Europe is on top, and China and Korea and Singapore and Hong Kong is down here? What happened in 50 years to flip that? If it's about genetics, what happened in 50 years to flip that? Our scoring so much higher than people in the United States, okay? Then the idea that people have, maybe they're wired in a different way. Maybe they're wired in a different way. Maybe it's about genetics for them, because what else could explain that? Because we go back to genetics.
노력의 차이라기엔 항상 너무 큰 격차가 나기 때문에 타고난 지능의 차이가 있다고 생각한다는 것이었습니다. 여기에 인도 학생이 반박에 나서는데.
So I don't think it's genetics still. I mean.
Look in the camera and say why it's not genetics, because there are people who think that it is.
So a bit about me from Edison, and as he said, there's a lot of Asian people there, and the high school I went to was JP, if you guys know what that is. It's a very competitive school filled with a lot of Asians. So for me at least, if one kid did this, and this, and that, you're destined to do that and more. So I don't think this is really genetics. I think that a lot of people in Singapore maybe did really well, and then all these parents are like, dude, you gotta do well. Like, come on, get your game up. And then kind of like did better.
You got a whole society built around education in a different kind of way and putting resources into education. The problem is we want to think that IQ is genetic, and it is at a level for individuals. There's no question that some of you who have super high IQs or some of you have really low IQs, it's like you're wired in some kind of way. Like, that's okay for an individual. But when it's a whole group, it's really, really difficult. But the problem is we don't get away from this stuff. We don't get away. And we look at each other and we look at these physical differences and we imagine that they must be real at a deeper level. And Asians are, why are Asians better at math, bro?
Because we got more training on math and...
When did you start learning calculus? What age? How old were you when you started learning calculus?
In the middle school, I think.
Middle school? Dude, it was 12th grade for me. And even then I failed it. Middle school?
Yes.
You say that like, doesn't everybody do that? No, dude, not everyone does that, all right? Dude, when did you start learning calculus? In like sixth grade?
No.
Fifth grade?
I think it was like 11th grade.
11th grade, yeah. All right. Yeah.
결국 어떤 것이 정답인지는 알 수 없습니다. 아무리 비슷한 사람끼리 모아도 모두가 다른 사람이고 다른 특징, 다른 장점을 갖고 있을 테니 말이죠.
You need to understand this. You want to understand this. Okay? So all you sports people, black people aren't really good at basketball because they jump higher, all that kind of shit. None of that. Black people would be great at hockey if they played hockey in large numbers. Hockey players would be great at basketball if they weren't skating around on rinks up in Canada. And some of them who do play basketball are great at basketball, but hockey's the thing. Maybe some groups are genetically superior to other groups. Let me explore that. Maybe that explains some of this. Those of you who are, you know, 100% into evolution, right? You think like evolution explains everything. Well, where's the first spark of consciousness come from? And those of you who believe in God and think that God created everything, where did God come from? You know, this is the mystery of life. It's a mystery. So it's all mystery. Just sit with the mystery. And the two can go together. It's not a problem.
전 세계 시청자들이 채팅으로 아시아인, 특히 한국인과 공부에 관한 다양한 의견을 나누었고 자연스럽게 재능과 유전이라는 주제로 이어졌습니다. 아시아인의 평균 소득이 높다는 통계, 그리고 아시아인은 유전적으로 지능이 높다는 편견에 대해 학생들이 직접 반론을 제기하기도 했습니다. 노력만으로 설명하기 어려운 격차가 있다는 시각과 결국 사람마다 다른 특징과 장점이 있다는 반대 시각이 교차하면서 논의는 점점 더 깊어졌습니다. 한국과 아시아 학생들의 이야기를 통해 재능과 성취가 단순히 유전으로만 설명될 수 없는 복합적 주제임을 다시금 확인할 수 있었습니다. 오늘 우리가 본 토론은 한국 사회에서 자주 등장하는 교육 성취 담론과도 맞닿아 있다는 점에서 더 큰 의미가 있었습니다. 과연 노력과 환경, 그리고 타고난 재능 중 어떤 요소가 개인의 성취를 더 크게 좌우할까? 시청자 여러분들은 어떻게 생각하시나요? 오늘 강의는 여기까지입니다. 시청해주셔서 감사합니다. 강의를 해주신 샘 리처드 교수님 감사합니다.